guys, welcome to Hip Hughes History. It was Thomas Jefferson that said an educated citizenry is a vital requisite for our survival as a free people. And that's why we're going cray cray for the learning on the internets and the YouTubes. We're gonna see if we can't knock out the Seventh Amendment to the Bill of Rights. It's not gonna take long, straightforward, short and sweet. Seven is civil, baby. So let's do it bang bang style. Let's do the learning on the YouTubes. All right, let's read the words. Are you ready for me? Watch this.
In suits at common law, where the value in controversy shall exceed $20, the right of trial by jury shall be preserved, and no fact tried by a jury shall be otherwise re-examined in any court of the United States than according to the rules of common law.
All right, there's really two parts here, guys, and they're really straightforward. The first part is in reference to a jury trial in a civil case. According to common law, and this goes back to Great Britain and kind of judicial decisions that occurred over there springing forth from the Magna Carta. So there's a couple of exceptions to common law, but basically what it means is if it's not a criminal trial, that's taken care of the Sixth Amendment, that you have the right to a jury trial if there's a lawsuit, if you're suing somebody or being sued. Except for maritime cases, which is like naval kind of stuff, if you're suing the government or if it has something to do with patents, pretty much any other lawsuit type of case, you have the right to a jury trial. That has been defined as having at least six members on the jury. So it has to be a unanimous decision. Now, this is for federal cases, of course. This is an amendment that has not been selectively incorporated, which means that the judicial branch has not interpreted the 14th Amendment. No state shall deny its citizens equal protection and the due process clause, and has basically incorporated most of the rights in the Bill of Rights, but not number 7, but it doesn't matter because every state has jury trials for civil trials. Now the second part, in reference to this kind of facts thing, basically the idea is there's a big worry that Article 3 and Section 2 specifically, and you can look at that right up on the wall, basically is saying that the Supreme Court has the right to review appellate decisions based on fact. So the big worry is that the courts that are appointed are going to be able to basically nullify jury decisions. So on facts. So if a jury decides that, I don't know, somebody gets awarded X amount of money, or that there was a certain type of pollution that led to a disease, and that disease now needs to be compensated by a company, or something like that. The fear is that because of Article 3, Section 2, that the federal branch would be able to change the facts of decisions that were made by juries. So basically what this says is, I don't think so. I think what's going to happen is you can have appellate jurisdiction. You can look at constitutional issues, but you're not going to re-examine. It's called the re-examine clause. You're not going to re-examine the facts that were found true by a jury. It's none of your business. It was Hamilton and I think Fed 83 that argued this wouldn't be a problem, that it would just go back and there'd be another jury trial anyway. And he was confident that jury trials would be secured in common law through congressional action. But the anti-feds were having none of it. They were like, I don't think so, Alexander. So the Seventh Amendment. All right, we certainly want you to subscribe. If you haven't subscribed, what are you doing? Click the button right there and you'll zip through the internets onto the YouTubes where you can subscribe and get updates and new videos and such like that. Check the description below. We have tons of other EDU channels that you probably should be watching. And we'll see you next time. You know what I'm gonna say, where attention goes, energy flows. There we go, that's true all the time. So family tomatoes, and they're going for a little family picnic, they're going for a walk, and the little baby tomato in the back falls way back. So the mother tomato's got to kind of jog all the way in the back, and when she gets there, she steps on the little baby and she goes, catch up.